Hey there, everybody. This is Sam reporting to you live from the practice rooms at Hoffman Music Center. And today, in my hands, I've got one of the craziest instruments I've ever laid eyes on. It's a real sight to behold, the Chagrel Killer Queen B-flat Flugelhorn. If you've seen other Chagrel instruments, maybe you've seen their Gonch horn, you'll notice the similarity in the bent bell and the rotary valve setup up top. But while that is a trumpet, this is a flugelhorn. It takes a normal flugelhorn shank mouthpiece. It's got a flugelhorn lead pipe here that you tune the instrument with. It's a little bit hard to get a grip on because there's no pull nubs, but you know, it's just one of the foibles of the instrument. In any case, this is a super unique horn. It's got these rotors here that are actuated, you know, kind of with the tops of the fingers rather than with the sides, so you might consider this a top action rotary valve setup. It's not as officially so as the Chagrel Raven. If you haven't seen my review on that, it's going to be out there for you. But in any case, this is an absolutely crazy horn. I've never played such an expensive flugel in my life, so This is history right here that we're making. The Killer Queen Flugelhorn has some interesting features, from the shape to, you know, the ergonomics and how you hold it and how you play it. It's just got two normal water keys there and on the third valve slide, as you would expect. It's got a thumb trigger down there, if you can see it. You press that with your thumb and the third slide extends as needed for your low Ds and C sharps, which is pretty cool. I like having it in the thumb rather than the other fingers here, which wrap around this brace. And overall, although it's quite a large and beefy instrument, it's fairly easy to hold even if you have pretty small hands like me. Now, on the business end of things, you've got just your normal pinky hook that you can place on top of or inside. I really like their design with the curved brace here. It really allows the thumb to sit nicely. And overall, it's just a very comfortable and relaxed instrument to hold once you get used to it. You'll notice the Chagrel Killer Queen is quite a beefy horn. It's got a large bell profile and bell, you know, flare here. It's a lot of fun to play. The highs and lows all speak pretty nicely. Overall, I would say the low register has quite a lot of bark and it takes a lot of air to play in the low register. Otherwise, you will get a double buzz. So it's not a very forgiving instrument in that respect. But when you use the right type of air, it really rewards you with the right kind of sound. Pedals are nice and fat. You'll hear them in a clip there. High register sounds a little, you know, nice and fluffy like you would expect on a flugelhorn. And overall, I would say all the registers are really there the way you need them. So, in the end, the Chagrel Killer Queen is going to be quite an expensive investment if you choose to make it, but really this is such an amazing horn, and it's a real treat to be able to play even if this is not going to be my horn by any stretch of the imagination. So I hope you enjoyed, and we'll see you on the flip side.